What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Edge of Tech. I'm Jim, and this is the brand new Bambu Lab P1S. I am super stoked to have this thing on the bench today, and we're gonna do this in real time. We are gonna unbox this thing and set it up in real time, and man, we're gonna see how it goes. I think it's gonna be a pretty awesome machine. From what I understand, it's an enclosed P1P, but we're gonna find out. So we're gonna do this together in real time. No editing, no cuts, no anything special like that. Just completely seeing this for the first time together. So again, this is the Bambu Lab P releases today. And there goes my camera for some reason. Not sure why. Super weird. I'll have to figure that out. But we're going to pop this bad boy open, and hopefully that doesn't happen too often. And in the top, no top-down camera today. We just got the classic Bambu Lab wrap, which is full of some good old-fashioned wrappings. So corner protectors, which is awesome to see. Classically, the Bambu Lab is wrapped in plastic inside, so you have to pull the plastic open. I actually like that a lot in case the box were to get wet or something like that, right? So let's see, can we just pull this out? We can. Look at that. So I'm going to leave it right there for now. Inside the box, we have some more bubble wrap that went all the way around the printer. I love to see this since the very first one I got last May. They have really stepped up their game as far as packaging. So, we got some more filament. We got some support for PLA. We got some PLA green, it looks like, and some PLA basic orange, which is great. There you go. That's what those look like there. And if you didn't already guess it, this does come with the AMS combo kit. So that's what we're looking at here. It looks like they packed the AMS inside, which is normal. They've done that on other machines. Pretty much anything that ships with an AMS. So here we go. Moment of truth as we see this together. Man, it's black. I could tell you right away, it feels like a plastic. I'm guessing like the X1. I'm just guessing because I don't actually have an X1. I have some X1 carbons and I have the P1P, but I don't have the X1. So yeah, that's what it looks like. Super nice. I really love the look so far. Right on the top is a get started little booklet here. So I'm going to fold that over and I'm going to take the sticky off that. It is fully taped up, as you can see. There we go. Ooh, the Bambu Lab logo there. This thing is very slick looking. It's like the dark mode model of the X1 carbon. So, you know, I like it. So if you're watching this at home, currently I'm actually recording this early so I can release it on release day. I literally got this Tuesday, and it is Tuesday night at about 10:19 p.m. my time. But I don't think we're allowed to put videos up until they release, maybe on the 13th, and it's currently the 11th. So I could be wrong about that. If they release it early, I'll drop this video early. But I did want to do this. So if you have questions, we're going to do this live, questions and answers. So shoot them out there while we're going along, and I'll do my best to answer them as we go along and watch me with this. So the top comes off, and there's a lot of plastic cover on it here. And it looks like it's kind of like in a plastic envelope, which is good. Nice packaging. Get stuck in my hair there. So I would suggest, highly suggest a knife. If you can see right here, it's kind of hard to see. There's actually some foam like built into the packaging. So I have not seen a recent X1. I haven't seen any of the recent machines get shipped to me with like the recent packaging or any of the updated stuff like that. Everything I have is, everything I have that's new has come since the P1P, or hasn't come since the P1P was released. So I know people in the chats were talking about, you know, how they stepped up their game for packaging too. So it's good to see. It is good to see. The first one I got, if you remember, last May, had a big dent in the back of it. So this one, not so much. No dents. We'll get to the back of it though. Man, this plastic's on here. I probably should have just cut it all the way through. But there we go. Try not to get too many fingerprints all over it as I pull it open. It is glass. I'm pretty sure, yeah, that's definitely glass. It's kind of a smoked look. I like it. Cool. We're gonna go around the printer here and get some more of this tape off so we can get the door open and see what this stuff's made out of. Again, if you have questions, shoot them in the comments while we're going along. If you're watching this during the live stream debut, if you're watching this after that, throw your comments in the comment section. I do my best to respond. I can't always get to all of them, but I want, you know, I try. So there's that. Again, this door, as you can see, very well wrapped. There's more foam pieces right here in the door, which is great. Not sure how we get this out though, because it's, I have to turn this towards me. Cool. It's actually lighter. I think it's lighter than the X1 carbon, mostly because I believe the body is going to be plastic of some sort. There we go. That's not too bad. Slides right off. And I can kind of show you from behind these little pieces here. They're like foam, you know, so they're really stepping it up as far as trying to protect these things and shipping, which is great to see. If I flip this back around towards you, you see the front door now. It is also a glass. Inside, we have our AMS, as you can see there. And in the top, if I can flip this down for you to see, everything is packed in right in the top, as we've seen before in other printers. So we'll just start unpacking. So we are about 8 minutes and 27 seconds in. Again, I'm doing this in real time. There's not going to be any editing. There's not going to be anything like that. This AMS looks updated from the ones I have too, just from first glances, which is nice to see. I'm willing to bet I got to unlock it from the bottom probably. A giant pack of desiccant, and I want to jump over to the Bambu Lab P1S combo. P1S combo. Let's see. That's the booklet, right? So here we go. There is an unlock in the front to unlock the AMS, it looks like. So we're going to do that. I just got to turn it towards me so I can actually see it. Ah, yeah. The two, turn it towards you. You can see be careful there. You can see the two red arrows in here. Those tell you where to unlock it. I've always liked that they did that. They make it super easy for us to unpackage these. And I believe going to be a 2 or 2.5. Let's find out. I do have to turn it so I can actually get to it. Let's see what we got here. Oh, it is a two. It says a two. It is a two. So we will twist those out and unlock them. Again, we're doing this live, no cuts. So there's no B-roll in this video. There's no like cutting angles, showing you anything. We're just going to do it. So I got the first two screws out. That should allow our, put those over there. That should allow the AMS, if I turn that towards you, to slide. And it does. Boom. And we have one brand new P1S AMS. I think it's just a new AMS system. Let's see. Does this have a version on it, just for argument's sake? Model SA001. It does not say if there's a version number on the bottom, but hey, you never know. I thought maybe somewhere it might, maybe. But very, very light. Wow. I might have to check this against my original one, because this is super light. All right, what else do we got here? So the next thing we need to do is get the bottom locks off like normal, and then we need to get the cardboard out and pull the lock out and then connect our AMS. So pull these bottom locks off, pull the head of the AMS off, the head of the machine off there. There we go. Good, cardboard down. Oh. If you have not seen my maintenance video on these, it is so easy to do maintenance on these machines. It is so easy. Don't forget your sticker on the hot end. If you notice some of my videos, I forgot that for a long time. For a very long time, I forgot that. Okay, so now I need to go in and I need to, it looks like, unlock a bunch of these. Hoping they're the same size. I might have to lower my desk to get to it. Oh, let's see. My little guy turned my power off here. Got to unlock my desk so I can lower it so I can get to it. Here we go. Now it'll be a little easier for me to get to, and it looks like there are 1, 2, 3, 4 bolts. Don't forget to take the foam out of your poop chute. Very important. You don't want a foamy poop chute. Come on. Oh, is this the wrong size? I wonder if they changed the size on me. Nope, I just had to actually get it in the screw. So I'm just gonna unlock the 4 bolts that are holding the AMS mount down. There's one, I believe that one's completely unlocked now. And this is more tricky to do like this than you know here. So it does look like there's a side fan in this, just so you know, and a light. Let's see. There's a side fan, a light, and a camera. A side fan, a light, and a camera in this. So I believe they started putting the camera and the light in the P1Ps. Wow. I'm doing a real good job here of unscrewing this. All right. I love using these T-handles, but sometimes I should just grab out my regular old, my bit drivers, because it would make it a little easier. But slide that over for me. Ooh, now I got to find this one. That one is tricky. Almost. We got almost 3 of the 4 screws done. We're 14 minutes in, and that's with me talking. So it's not that bad. This one I can't see. Where are you? There you are. So once again, if you have questions about the P1S, I will be on live answering these questions during the viewing of this video. After that, I'll do my best to answer any questions in the comments we can. In the description, you'll find a link. It'll be an affiliate link, obviously, to grab one of these if you want to, or any other Bambu Lab products. It definitely helps the channel out, and I really appreciate it. Oh, just so close. So close. I got one that's like a couple threads from being out. So something I noticed right away with the enclosure, this does have a built-in cable chain on the that did not come on the P1P before. There we go. There we go. That's the bracket that mounts the P1P. Now we're going to have four bolts or four screws in here that lock that build plate down so it can't move during shipping. There is a little piece of styrofoam right there. So we're going to release these four bolts real quick too. So you have four bolts for the AMS, four bolts for the locking down, locking down the build area here, the build plate. And I'm doing a really good job of being backwards here, trying to show this. I should grab a little light and try to pump some light in here, but we're almost done. I don't know. I believe this is literally an enclosed P1P. So I know a lot of people wanted an enclosed P1P. You know what? There might be only two. Nope, three. There's only three, not four. Whoa. Again with this, huh? There we go. Sorry about that. Now you know I'm doing it live. You know what? Well, I'm doing it in real time here because something's up where it keeps dropping me from this side. It doesn't do that during our Hotmakes Monday show. So it's got to be something from this side of the room. We'll find out. It's very interesting that it does that. Again, it doesn't do that during Hotmakes. So it makes me wonder what could be causing it. Maybe it's a cable. I know I bypassed the ATEM Mini today. I have an ATEM Mini right over here that's like a video switcher, and it's been giving me a lot of craziness with color and flashes. So we bypassed that. I have a new piece of equipment that should be here in the next couple days. Thank you, Amazon Prime Days. Speaking of Amazon Prime Days, hopefully you got some cool stuff. If you needed any cool stuff. Wow, this is much harder to do this from this angle. Okay, second screw is just about out. There we go. Last one is all the way in the back in the, so it's like a triangle, right? So it's all the way in the back. If you've unboxed one of these before, it is just like we've seen in the past. I'm gonna spin this around in the sake of time. And try to do this quick. Try to do this as quick as I can. This might be better to done with one of my bit drivers, but I'm trying to do it with a T-handle because I love T-handles. I love them. Check out the Amazon store for tool. I think it's under tools or something. It's in the description below, and you'll find the T-handles that I use. They just make life easy. Unless it's this position. So let me know in the comments right now. Are you excited for a new Bambu Lab printer? Knowing that this is probably, this wasn't the big one everybody was waiting for, but this is a new one. And that's a big step. That's a big step. So I see something else right away. I could tell you that this does have the carbon filter in it. So it is there is a filter. I just pulled the tape off of it and opened it up, and there is a filter in there. So this does, sorry, my mic got crazy. This does have a filter in it. Being enclosed makes sense. So we are all unscrewed. I'm gonna get the last piece of foam out. I need to raise this bad boy up in a second here. But first we need to put the screen on, it looks like. I'm gonna turn this back around towards you guys. Get that out of here. Have a quick drink. So, our AMS. Wow, this comes with a lot of stuff. You know what? This comes with a whole bunch of extra PTFE tubes. I don't know if new ones have been doing that. And if they have, that is awesome. But I'll show you what I mean in a minute once we get this thing on and ready to go. Okay. Just going to get rid of the T-handles. So we're rocking it. Now it says we need to unbox everything. We need to put the... So the next thing it says to do is put the AMS on. So we're going to follow their instruction. Again, it does have a cable chain in here, which is really nice. One thing I did on my P1P is I ordered the cable chain for the P1P. And yeah, so it's kind of nice that this one comes with it. Glass top goes on there like that. Makes sense because they have these parts, right? These are already parts that they have. Now what we're going to do, I'm going to spin this around so you can see the back. This, what do you think about this shell, this color? And I just saw that happened. That is crazy. I just saw the camera go out like that. So maybe it's not the ATEM Mini. Maybe it's something else being crazy, because something is causing that to happen from this side of the room. Okay. Let me know what you think of the color. I actually dig it a lot. Like I said, it's kind of like the dark mode X1 carbon. So there's the back. We have the buffer tube, the poop chute here. And we're going to, you know, you'll mount your spool holder here. What it wants us to do right now is put on our AMS. So we're going to do one of these sweet, sweet pulls. For all of you guys that like that, boom, boom, boom. A lot of plastic on this. All right. So look at that. Look at that colors together. That looks so good. Very cool. So there you go. Pop that out like this. And this comes around and plugs in to your buffer tube like that. In a second here, I'll grab some more parts out of it. So inside, more stuff taped down. It's a whole bunch of spare parts. I say spare parts. It's spare PTFE. One long and a whole bunch of short ones. So if you need to replace the PTFE tubes that are in here, they give them to you now. That's pretty dang awesome. I like that a lot. You know, like I said, I haven't had a new one of these in a long time. And it is really cool to see, you know, the changes that they're making. I think that they're making really good changes as they go along. And there you go. Look at that. These are desiccants, and they're in plastic. So I popped open those trays on the inside of the AMS. If you do this, don't forget to take your desiccant out of the plastic. I know some people left theirs in for quite a while before they realized they were in plastic. I got those comments on the videos in the last year here. So I'm just going to pop these back in because that's what you do. They're just little covers that go, if you have not seen this, they're just little desiccant covers. So they sit inside and they clip in, and your desiccant, you know, just sits in there. Some people print, I've showed this before on my upgrades video. Some people print a piece that allows you to put loose desiccant in, which is great as well. So we're at about 25 minutes. A lot of me talking, a lot of me fumbling through those screws backwards so I could still try to get you guys a shot from the front, which I normally wouldn't do if we were just putting a, you know, printer together, right? So I got my AMS cables. This box comes like this, all packaged nicely. Does have a glue stick. It does come with, hey, you know what? It does come with a gold textured PEI plate here. Look at that. It's like a gold color. Wow. I haven't seen that either. I still have the original black textured PEI plates. So there's that. So we'll get that going in a second. Man, this camera. What is happening, Stream Labs? The link is, I have a capture card that runs from here. Well, this cable runs down that way, and then it goes into a capture card. But you think if the capture card was bad, it would do that for Monday Show Hotmakes, because I use the same capture card for that, and this has never happened. So now I'm beginning to think I have it straight in over there. I guess I don't know. We'll find out. So it looks like we got a couple cables here. So they gave us, cool, just making sure. All right, so the four pin goes under here like this. Is it still backwards? It is still backwards. And this one goes over here, I can see, like this. Nah, that can't be right. I think I have those backwards. I do have them backwards. Now the fun part of getting that one out real quick. Idea. When in doubt, a little plastic clip. And you got to push the little lever in there. Oh, maybe. Wait a minute. Oh, they changed it on me. Yeah, they changed it on me. Okay. For now, we're going like this. I'm good with that. It's probably fine. I don't know if it's backwards or not, but I should have looked. Should have looked first. This one here goes from any either side of this AMS down around and into the buffer tube, just like that. AMS is officially connected now. Okay. Now it wants us to put on the spool holder. So we're going to do that. Oh, just got to be able to see it. Hey, the screen is here. Screen is the same. Just so you guys know, screen is the same. People are going to either love or hate that. I don't mind it. It doesn't bother me, mostly because I never use it. I send everything from either Bambu Studio or Orca Slicer straight to the printer, and I almost never use the screen. The only time I think I use the screen is maybe when I'm changing filament. I think that's it. So I need the T-handle again, because we need to screw in our, where are we at here? I need to screw in our spool holder, which is just that piece there. Just like the other ones, these sit in, and it looks like they didn't change this much. That's one thing that I kind of wanted a change on. I forgot I got to take this one out. So there's one screw you take out. Like that, it's a shorty. And then you replace it with one in your spool holder. Now, if you're never going to use this spool holder, you don't have to do this part. Some people will and some people won't. So, yeah, if you're not going to use it, don't put it on. That's fine. It's all good. There we go. My T-handle for the win on this one because it's long enough to go all the way through there and suck that in. So I don't believe I'm going to need these anymore, but just in case, I'll leave them out. So that's on now. I got the heat bed unlocked. Insert the LCD is next. And that's it. Tis it. So I want to see what they include in this. We're going to look and see what they include as well in here. But we can pull that. There we go. Let me just check how we're doing. We're doing good. Still there. Camera. I mean, doing as good as it says we're doing, right? So I just pulled the cover off of the screen. Some people will be freaking out right now, but that's okay. Let's turn this back around. So our screen is going to go in the same place right here. And it's just to pull off that. Also, it looks like there is SD card in here, by the way. So there is that. I don't know if they started including them before or not. That I can't speak. Let me know in the comments. But there is one, and it's hard to read here. Micro SD. I cannot read it. It's so dark. And the writing is so light. That is crazy. I have no idea how big this thing is. We'll check it when we fire up the printer. How about that? Backwards when you put it back in. So the front of the card goes this way. So the card's backwards if you're looking at it. So now we're going to get our screen. This may be the trickiest part of everything, right? Putting this little cable in the screen. Woo! And especially if I'm doing it like this because I'm kind of backwards. But it just pops into the back of the screen like that. And we're in. Whew. Now I made fingerprints, so there's that. The little cables, they just kind of sit in the back of the screen. There's a part for them. And I definitely put some fingerprints on that bad boy. So we're gonna clean that off. This thing is brand new. We don't want fingerprints, right? So there's that. And at this point, with me messing around, we're built. It looks like about 30 minutes. But that's also with me trying to do this backwards while I'm filming. So let's take a look what comes in here, and let's pop this back up to normal height. There we go. Oop. Get up there. There we go. So, whoosh, there we go. Bambu Lab P1S. It is super sick looking. I really like the color. I know that doesn't matter a lot in 3D printing. And with the P1P, you can make any shell you want. That's one of the best things about it. But, glue stick. Power cable. A whole bunch of stuff here. So a really long, nice Allen wrench if you want to get those screws out with this. There's a couple of Allen wrenches, a nozzle cleaner, and then in here, let's see what we got in this bag. So this is a bunch of lubricant grease. So they actually are giving you a whole bunch of stuff here. So there's some extra wipers. These gold ones, there's four of them like this. You can kind of see them against my shirt or against here. This is lubricant grease, is what it says on here, which when you're doing your maintenance, that's awesome. It's 1 gram each, it says. In this bag, we're going to have some terminal grease here. I'm sorry, thermal grease. I read that wrong. So when you're swapping out your hot end, I think. A whole bunch of extra parts for extruder, for hot end. So there's extra parts here. It looks like there is the classic razor for your scraper. Highly suggest, really seriously, highly suggest printing this. It's a model that's already on. I just found another one of these. So they give you 5 1-gram pieces of lubricant. Printed phone holder. There's a kit here for a printed phone holder. And if I remember right, if I pop this open, 2 more blades. So there's 2 more cutting blades in here too. So they give you a pretty good amount of stuff. Now, one thing, I stand corrected. Hang on, let me drop all this stuff back in here. Let me know in the comments what you think of all the stuff so far. They gave you a whole bunch of lubricant grease, some thermal paste, two wipers, a bunch of extra screws and bolts, the scraper blade, a phone holder piece. So there's that. And on the other side here, I just noticed it. It looks like they're giving us an extra hot end. It is. So this is the Bambu Lab 0.4 hot end. It's a spare hot end. If you can see that, it's kind of hard to see. There we go. So awesome. You know what? I need to put another one in my collection. You know what's interesting is this is different. Let me see something. I don't know if you can tell very easily, but this one here is one of my originals. It's black. This one here is the new one, and it's not so much black. It's like it's like a gunmetal. I don't know what color this really is. It's like, I'm going to go with gunmetal. It's like it's really cool looking. So cool. Extra nozzle. Jeez. Extra hot end. You do have to remove the fan and stuff from the other hot end to use this. I have a video, so check that out. It's super easy. 5 minutes or less. I'm going to toss some extra screws in here just so I don't lose them in the shop. So the next thing, all we got to do is link this thing up. Glue stick, you're going in. We need to power it on. Make sure it powers on. Link it up to our software, my account first, I think. And then check it out. So let's see. We're going to power bind it. Power it on, bind it. It says take out the desk kit. Don't forget that in your AMS if you get the AMS with it. And we're going to rock and roll through Bambu Studio. While it's powering on, let's see. There we go. Cool. While it's powering on, we will read an email. That's what I was doing. Okay. So I'm going to move this over here so it's a little bit closer to my power. And there we go. I'll move over the other side there so I can see. So there we go. Good for the light. It's powering on. First time. So I kind of went through everything it came with. We unboxed it. We got it ready. Man, nice big piece of desiccant comes in the packaging. If you have questions at this point, let me know. Again, if it's not during the live viewing, I will respond to them in the comments if you drop them in the comments. So I need to see what's going on. It says before first use, make sure you've read the user manual. Good. Wait 3 seconds. Good. I'm going to get my app ready. Speaking of my app, it looks like my it looks like Morpheus just finished in the other room. One thing that you'll know with one thing that you should know with these, if you don't know already, is there's something called Bambu. Bambu Studio is what you use on your computer. Bambu Handy is for your app on your phone, tablet, that kind of thing. Please make sure that you've removed the screws. Done it. Let me know where you are. We're in North America. Now I want to, it wants me to scan the QR code on the screen, which is standard. You can do setup later if you want. If you want to keep this thing offline, that kind of thing, you can do setup later. Totally fine. Bypass it. In my case, we are going to go to me. We're going to go scan a QR code. And I'm not going to show you said QR code just in case, you know, you want to get in. It says confirm to bind. Tap to pair with the printer. Pair and connect. Oops, just pair. There we go. It's giving us a number here. Yep. Pair. Pair. There we go. And now it's asking for your Wi-Fi. So I'm just going to drop my Wi-Fi in. You do not have to do this. Just a heads up. You don't have to do this. Now I'm questioning myself if I just put the right Wi-Fi password in. Anyways, it'll let me know if I didn't. But you don't have to do the Wi-Fi. You don't have to bind it like this. You can do setup later. Go right into the printer and start using it with an SD card. So there is that. So now it's doing the binding. I'm pretty sure I put the password in correctly. So we're going to find out in a second. Please confirm you've removed the lock screws. There's 1, 2, and 3. We're going to say we have. Finally, let's run the self-test. And I'm going to spin that around so you can see it happen. We are, you know, we're pretty good as far as this video goes. Now it's going to run through the self-test. And we're going to be set up. We're going to be ready to go. I'm going to pull the foam out of the bottom here when I can. Like that. It's doing stuff inside. There we go. Man, this is a nice looking printer. A little bit of tape over here. I didn't get off. There we go. So once more time, if you have questions about the Bambu Lab P1S, shoot them in the chat now. Man, so far so good. This is literally business as usual so far. I mean, this is an enclosed P1P. I really like the color of the case. I don't know why I like the dark color. It matches the P1P, right? The AMS looks nice. I want to check this. This might be bigger. This might be bigger than my original AMSs. It's interesting because that would be a good thing. That would mean they made it wider for more spools to fit. We'll check that out. You'll see a video soon probably on that. But it's running through the self calibrations now, and we're rocking. We are rocking. Cool. And this will integrate. This is going to integrate right into Bambu Studio. It will, you know, it'll integrate into Orca Slicer once they add it. As soon as Bambu Studio releases the updated version of Bambu Studio that has this in it, right? I'm thinking Orca Slicer will be right behind. Yeah, very cool. It looks good. Looks like it's going to function good. I mean, obviously we haven't done any tests yet, but I wanted to give you guys a first look. I don't want to make this too long, but this is the first look of the Bambu Lab P1S. Unboxing quick, setup quick, and yeah, now we're just running through calibrations. I'm going to get this bad boy printing, and we're going to go from there. But I think it's nice. If it performs like a P1P, we don't have any problems, right? I like that some of the colors are different. The hot end color was different. The bed, flex bed, or the flexible build plate, I'm sorry, was like gold color instead of black. I don't know if they've been doing that for a while or not. I should probably look into that. But like I said, this is going to be unedited, uncut. This is me walking through things like I'm seeing them first time like you are right now. So awesome. It looks great. I think we're going to let this thing calibrate. I'll get some prints going and I will get them out on the social medias as soon as we can. We're about halfway through the self-test, as you can see the little arrow there. Everything inside is plastic. Just a heads up on that. There is the fan. Like I said, there's a light. Everything else looks the same. I mean, it does have the filter, which is good to know. If you're wondering if it has the filter, it does come with the built-in filter. Which is great. Yeah. I think we're business as usual. Bambu Lab, nice work on this. We're going to do some test prints. We're going to get this thing rocking and rolling. And, you know, we're going to check it out. But if it's, you know, if the other printers that they have put out are any indication of what this thing is going to do, I don't think we have anything to be worried about. So call me a fanboy, call me whatever you want right now. I tell you what, I've had really good success with all of my Bambu Lab printers. I have several now. And I, you know what? I've had awesome success. They're perfect printers to start on. They're super easy to use. The slicer makes it easy. The printers make it easy. If you're not a fan of the screen, that's okay. Again, I rarely use it. I send everything from my computer to the machine. So there you go. But this is the Bambu Lab P1S. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you everybody for spending a little bit of time with me. Questions, drop them in now or drop them in the comments and I will get to them as many as I possibly can. And you'll probably see this thing pop up some more coming up in the future. So stay tuned. I'm sure there's going to be a bunch of videos on this today when this goes live. So everybody have a great one. Thank you so much for being here once again. Keep rocking, keep printing, and keep coming. I really appreciate you guys being here. See you guys later.